We have some amazing ladies' choirs in Bexhill. They work really hard, give a lot of pleasure to a lot of people. They produce some brilliant concerts. So I've written this poem especially for them. It's called Ladies Who Sing. The choir of lovely ladies formed a line to take their chairs. Dressed in black with yellow kerchiefs, they approached the stage in pairs. At the back were all the climbers who could safely cope with height, with the small ones in the front row, as the space was rather tight. There were plenty of sopranos who could sing the notes in tune, and rather fewer altos, but their voices filled the room. And a lady in the corner who had caused the group concern whether she would ever manage to sing only when her turn. And the rather bossy Mary, who told others what to do, and dear Vera on the final seat, as she might want the loo. And the master in his jacket, looking dapper as can be, pointing upwards with his baton, mouthing, "Please all look at me." Then dear Julie in the middle, who had begged to join the choir, though her pitch was somewhat challenged as she tried to sing far higher. They had struggled with the crotchets, juggled quavers and repeats, felt depressed at their slow progress in the last rehearsal meets, but the master tapped his baton, cast a glimpse towards the band, and as if they were one person, the whole choir began to stand. Music sheets before them, eyes directed at their king, he lifted up his baton, and the choir began to sing. Music filled the rafters with a mellow sound so clear, and as they reached their final notes, the audience gave a cheer.